The Messenger of Allah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, blessings and peace of Allah Azza wa Jal be upon him, said, there has come to you Ramadan, a blessed month. Allah has made it obligatory on you to fast. During it, the gates of paradise are opened, and the gates of hell are locked, and the devils are chained up. In it, there is a night that's better than 1,000 months. And whoever deprived of its goodness is deprived indeed. Brothers and sisters, we should all remember that the real meaning of fasting is not only giving up food and drink. Rather, Allah has enjoined fasting in order that we may attain piety. Hence, real fasting means refraining from sin and doing good deeds. The Messenger of Allah Azza wa Jal, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, blessings and peace of Allah Azza wa Jal be upon him, said, whoever doesn't give up false speech and acting upon it, Allah has no need of his giving up his food and drink. The Messenger of Allah, blessings and peace of Allah Azza wa Jal be upon him, said, it may be that all a fasting person gets from his fast is a hunger and thirst. And it may be that all a person who prays at night gets from his prayer is sleeplessness. Umar ibn al-Khattab, may Allah Azza wa Jal be pleased with him, said, fasting doesn't mean abstaining from food and drink only. Rather, it's also abstaining from lying, falsehood, and idle speech. Maymun ibn Mahran said, the easiest fasting is giving up food and drink. And we heard that the Sahaba and the early generation of this Ummah were keen for their fasting to be a purification for their souls as well as their bodies from free from disobedience and sin. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen wa sallallahu ala Sayyidina Muhammad wa alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. الحمد لله الذي أرسل رسوله بالهدى ودين الحق ليظهره على الدين كله وكفى بالله شهيدا وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له إقرارا به وتوحيدا وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا أما بعد ابن عباس may Allah عز وجل be pleased with him said the messenger of Allah blessings and peace of Allah عز وجل be upon him was the most generous of people, and he was at his most generous in Ramadan when he met Jibreel. He used to meet him every night in Ramadan and review the Quran with him. The Messenger of Allah, blessings and peace of Allah Azza wa Jal be upon him, was more generous than the wind. Al-Imam al-Nawawi said, this hadith teaches us several things, such as that is recommended to be more generous in Ramadan. Ibn al-Qayyim said, the Prophet Muhammad, blessings and peace of Allah Azza wa Jal be upon him, was the most generous of people, and he was at the most generous in Ramadan, when he would give a great deal of charity, do good deeds, read Quran, do dhikr, and i'tikaf. The Muslim must make the most of this blessed month by doing good deeds. These are some easy good deeds with a great reward. You can easily make them in Ramadan. It's recommended if someone insults you to respond in a better manner and say, I'm fasting. The Messenger of Allah, blessings and peace of Allah be upon him, said, fasting is a shield or protection. So there should be no obscene or offensive talk or behavior. If a person fights him or insults him, let him say, I am fasting. It's recommended for the fasting person to eat suhoor and delay it. The Messenger of Allah, blessings and peace of Allah Azza wa Jal be upon him, said, eat suhoor, for in suhoor there is a blessing. It's recommended to hasten to break the fast. The Messenger of Allah Azza wa Jal, blessings and peace of Allah Azza wa Jal, said, upon him said, the people will continue to be fine so long as they hasten to break the fast. It's recommended to break the fast with fresh dates. If none are available, then with dry dates. If none are available, then with water. Anas bin Malik said, the Messenger of Allah, blessings and peace of Allah Azza wa Jal be upon him, used to break his fast with fresh dates before praying. If there were no, then with dry dates. If there were no, then he would take a few sips of water. It's recommended when breaking the fast to say, Allahumma laka sumt wa ala rizqika aftart dhahaba adh-dhama wa btallat al-uruq wa thabata al-ajru insha Allah. It's recommended to sit after Fajr prayer until the sun rises, then pray two rak'ats. The Messenger of Allah, blessings and peace of Allah be upon him, said, whoever prays Fajr in congregation, then sits remembering Allah until the sun rises, then prays two rak'ats, will have a reward like that of Hajj and Umrah. It's recommended to give a great deal of sadaqah, charity, in Ramadan. The Messenger of Allah was asked, which sadaqah is best? He said, sadaqah in Ramadan. It's recommended for the fasting person to offer a great deal of dua, supplication. The Messenger of Allah, blessings and peace of Allah be upon him, said, there are three whose supplication will not be rejected. The just ruler, the fasting person until he breaks his fast, and the supplication of one who has been wronged. Keep in mind that the rewards are multiplied in this blessed month, and the sins as well. Don't think that Ramadan is only day, and after Maghrib you can do everything. No, Ramadan is day and night. Take advantage of this month to save yourself from the fire and to book your place in paradise. May Allah Azza wa Jal make us a look, a key to the good and a look to the evil. والحمد لله رب العالمين. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم اغفر لنا.